I'm going to show different examples of how metal works. Something that we must always remember about metal. It is pure reflection. It's going not only to reflect light, but it's also going to reflect dark places or shadows. It's really going to reflect everything, like a glass, or not a glass, a mirror. And don't forget, never forget gradient. I'm going to do a basic armor, okay? I'm going to show not only with metal, but also gold. But gold is a type of metal. Yeah, but you got what I meant. Like silver color and gold color. Because both cases are different. Now, I'm going to create some color, base color. It's going to be a metal, so it's going to be a dark base color because we're going to light it up. Oh, and never forget, your base color must be lower than your line art layer. I'll be adding some light. The light is going to come from here, okay? Here. Here we could add a really strong reflection already. It can change even to line dodge. So remember to refine your borders, your silhouette. Here it's darker. Why? It's close to a corner. Metals, something that people really don't get it, is when I say gradient, I mean it. You really need to have that smooth gradient, not this type of line thing here, you know? Make it darker. I'm using multiply mode, okay? Here, yes, soft light is your friend right here. Look at this, how beautiful this is. And now going to the lasso too. You see the movement, the place that I selected is just like the format of this metal. So now we are going to add some light in screen mode. I'm pressing Ctrl Shift and I to invert the selection. And I'm just making a darker place here on the side. Light's coming from above, it's going to cast a shadow right here. right here, darker color. Then I pick this color right here, that is the light one, the spotlight, and just place here. Just to make some effects and it's done. Now I'm going to show on the Magnemite. Just start with colors, I don't need to draw it. There's a shape that I don't wanna do, and I think, well, I could do this simply with another thing, like this, making the letter U. Let's make the shape of the U's thicker. Perspective here and shape. Nothing really important to the metal part, but really important if you want to be a good artist. Like, this is really important. To start making the shadows. You see that I'm only using hard shapes, I'm not using something soft here. In metal, it's really good for you to use hard shapes. But Gabs, in this tutorial right here above, you only use soft shapes. Why are you telling me to use a hard one? Because we're still in the beginning. I'm going even to do it on a separate layer, and I'm going to call you mask layer, and just make a mask to the number 2. Here, create clipping mask. I want to make this as if everything above the middle line, the horizontal line, is like sky, and everything below is floor. I select with magic wand. You can use the hotkey W. And you can add an even more lighter. Close to the eye, close to the eye, and really close to all places that receive shadow. Too black. Nothing too white or too black. Why doing realistic painting? Because it's not going to look realistic. Gradient here around the eye. Remember to always block your layer, to not paint outside it, okay? Okay, here we're going to refine even more the silhouette. Here we need to make this shape better. we'll be just adding some effects. With soft light, I'll be adding a warm color. Warm colors down, cool color up. Let's try screen, but with a really saturated color. And don't forget, we can add a ring light right now. Why not add a ring light?